students. Hope you are all in good health. Please take care in this season especially. Health is important and see that you do well. And I give you one small tip. You are busy with many things at home. Enjoy your time. And I request you to drink one glass of water every hour. It would be good if you drink hot water. Yes. So please do drink water. Yes. Let's come back to our lecture for today. Today's lecture is on concept of supply. Supply is very important in GST. Supply is the core word in GST. Because for every tax, there is an incident. If that incident takes place, the tax arises. Therefore, in the case of GST, supply of goods and services is the incident of tax. Supply of goods or services, or supply of goods and services, incident of tax. Now, we are going to look at the definition of supply. When we look to the definition of supply, supply tells us about six essential ingredients or six ingredients of supply. First one, there should be a supply of goods and services. Supply of goods and services, number one. Number one. Number two, the supply must be for a consideration. Number three, the supply must be during the course of business or furtherance of business. Your activity must come under the definition of business, and your activity, the supply, must be for the furtherance of business. And it is undertaken by a taxable person. Undertaken by a taxable person. And your product is a taxable product, a taxable supply. There are some supply which are exempted, and those are called tax-free supply. So supply will arise only if it is a taxable supply. And lastly, it must be made within the taxable territory. These six elements are essential for calling an item a supply. So for a transaction, the six element arises, then it is called supply. Now, what is a supply? Now the question comes. Somebody gave something to another person. Well, that can be called a supply. Okay? Right. We saw the ingredients. Now we will look at section 7.1, define supply. It's an inclusive definition. It says that supply includes sale, transfer, barter, exchange, license, rentals, lease, disposal. Okay. Now we will see one by one. Sale means sale of goods for cash or for deferred payment. What do you mean by deferred payment? Deferred payment is a transferred payment, a future payment. Or in other words, payment will be in installments. Deferred payment, yes. And there a transfer of title, which involves in transfer of property of goods from a seller to a buyer for agreed consideration. This is sale, and that is a sale of supply of goods. Supply of goods, and it attracts GST. Okay, sale means sale of goods for cash or for deferred payment, which involves in transfer of property in goods and transfer of title from a seller to a buyer for agreed consideration. Next term is transfer. It means transfer possession right in goods without transferring the ownership. Let us look at a case. A person transfers goods, but possession is transferred. Ownership is not transferred. Yes, and possession is transferred without ownership. So possession is transferred, so the person who received the goods can use the goods. This is called a transfer. This is a supply of service and attracts GST. Next one is transfer without transferring both ownership and possession right is not considered as supply. Transfer without transferring, if both ownership and possession rights is not transferred, then it cannot be considered as a supply. Suppose a car showroom, they send a car for demo. The car is sent for demo, so no ownership is transferred, no right to use is transferred. Therefore, yes, no possession is transferred. Therefore, this cannot be considered as a supply of service. So, no GST will be charged on this. I hope you understood the word transfer. Next, barter. Barter means exchange of goods or services with another kind of goods and services without using a consideration. Mr. Arun is a lawyer. Legal advice. Mr. Arun is a lawyer. He gives legal advice to Furniture Limited, and Furniture Limited in turn, as his legal advice fees, they give him a table and a chair. Okay, this is a barter, but here there is two-way supply. Yes, lawyer, for lawyer it is a taxable supply of service, and for Furniture Limited it is a supply of taxable goods. So lawyer must pay GST for services, and Furniture Limited must pay GST for supply of goods. Okay. Exchange, it is a transaction in which two persons mutually transfer the ownership of a thing for the ownership of another. That is exchange. Let us look at that. Suppose D is a dealer of cars, sell his cars 4 rupees 2 lakh to the buyer B, and the buyer exchange his old car that is given to D, and D considered it as 40,000 worth value, and the remaining, that is 2 lakhs minus 40,000, 1,60,000, is paid to D in cash. This is called an exchange. In this case, there is supply of goods. Yes, D is liable, supply of goods, 4 rupees 2 lakh GST on 2 lakh to be paid, and B, there also supply of goods, he is liable to for paying GST 4 rupees 40,000. That is exchange. Next is license. It is a right granted by one person to another person to do or continue to do in or upon the immovable property of the grantor is called license. Look at that. A is a software person. He is having a license, attendance software license, and he provide that license to different schools for rupees 2,000 each as a, for that license. This A allows the schools B, C, D, E, F and G to use this license, and he charges 2,000 per school. Okay. This is a supply of service, and A is liable to pay GST for this services. Clear? Another case you'll take. Vasai Virar Municipal Corporation. Yes. Give a license for mining activities to A Limited of Gujarat for rupees 2 lakh for 3 years. Here, look at that. In this case, A Limited is a recipient and Vasai Virar Municipal Corporation is the supplier of service. But, yes, this is a supplier of service, but A Limited is liable to pay GST under reverse charge mechanism. We saw that earlier. Reverse charge mechanism means, what do you mean by reverse charge mechanism? In general case, usual case, supplier is liable to pay GST to the government. But in certain cases, exceptional cases, the recipient is liable to pay GST to the government. That is called reverse charge. In this case, A Limited, the recipient of license for mining activity, yes, he is liable to pay GST under reverse charge because Vasai Virar Municipal Corporation, local authority, that is why. Okay. Now, rentals are periodical payments to be made for utilizing the property of other persons. Rental payments are done monthly. For example, Mr. A is the owner of a complex and he rent to B the premises of the complex for parking. This B has taken the premises of this property on rent for parking. This is a supply of service and A is liable to pay service tax, GST tax on this supply. Now, suppose the complex is a residential complex and Mr. A give the complex on rent, yes, say for rupees 25,000 per month. Here, let out property for residential purpose. This is exempted supply. This is considered as exempted supply when we go through the exempted list of supply, we will find this item. Okay, let out property for residential purpose, no tax will be charged because this is a supply of service, but it is an exempted service. Now, lease. Lease is an agreement made between a lessor and lessee, provides the right to use an asset, yes, for a particular purpose, for a consideration payable to the lessor for a particular period. This is called lease. This is also a supply of service and is taxable. GST, A is liable to pay GST. It can be operating lease or it can be financial. Operating lease is a leasing arrangement. There, right of ownership is not transferred. Yes, possession is transferred. Use is possible. In financial license, lessee gets the exclusive right to use the asset. And at the end of the period, the asset may not be transferred back to the lessor. Example, suppose a company purchase a car and give it to a person and he has to pay installments. So car is hypothecated to A till the person who received it pay all installments. When he pay all installments, the lease agreement ends and the car goes to the recipient. Okay. Right? Here, lessor will not get the asset back. This is called financial lease. Whether it is financial lease or operating lease, supply of service and taxable. Disposal also a supply. Disposal means the sale of assets by the business organization at the time of its wind up. When a company closes, they sell the assets. That is called disposal. Such disposals are also considered as supply liable for GST. Okay. Now, any import of services for consideration, whether not in the course or furtherance of business. Suppose you import any services which is not for furtherance of business, it is for your personal use, then also it is, even though it is not for furtherance of business, it is to be considered as a supply. Next item under the supply is some activities which are without consideration, but that is to be considered as supply. Those are items mentioned under Schedule 1. We will look at those activities which are to be considered as supply, even though these are without a consideration. Those items are mentioned.